Hello and welcome back to Exoshare Academy. Myself, Dr. Ruby Singh. So you know that in the series of these interviews, wherein I interview all my students, my colleagues, juniors and seniors, regarding and asking their experiences, like how they have prepared for their entrance exams and how, what are the questions they face during their PhD interviews, so that the others can also get an idea when they apply at various institutes. But to an exception to this series, today I have called one of my colleague and my very good friend, Purnima. So she is actually working at ICER Pune. So it's not like every time everyone wants to become a researcher or everyone wants to become a scientist. There are few people who are interested in doing research related, you know, science related work also. So we need such people also in our research area, right? So she is one among them, and she is responsible for handling all the BS MS students at ICER Pune. She carries out all the lab practicals and guide them, explain them the laboratory theories. So I welcome her, and let's see what are her experiences while working at the ICER Pune. Hi Purnima, how are you?
Hi Ruby, I'm fine. How are you?
I'm also fine. So since you know I have started the series of interviews so that the other students can also get motivated and inspired by you people. So for you, I would like to ask, like, can you share your experience and the questions which you have been, you know, interviewed during your ICER Pune job application? So can you just share your experience with us?
Yes, surely. No problem. So first of all, congratulations. I think this is a very nice activity that you've started for the students. It will definitely benefit them a lot. About my own ICER Pune journey, it started in 2016 when I had applied for the position of teaching assistant in biology. I have a biology master's degree and I have a BEd, and I was earlier teaching in a junior college in Pune. So I went for this interview knowing that it will be a great experience, even just to be interviewed in a panel which has ICER scientists. I thought it would be worth experiencing that. So the interview itself was in two rounds because the number of applicants was very large. There was only one position, and there were around 45 or 50 applicants. You know the situation, how it is generally. So we had two rounds of interviews. The first round of interview, it is generally a closed interview. So there are like four members of the panel who sit, and so the first round I remember was more about teaching, because they wanted to you know, see how I teach. It was a position for teaching assistant, so obviously they asked me to explain an experiment that you have already taught in the college. So I still remember I was explaining the experiment of a potato osmometer, which was an experiment which was done as a demonstration. Okay, so I was explaining the whole concept about how it's a potato, and then you keep it in the water, and then you have a sucrose solution inside, and it basically it is teaching the concept of endosmosis, and you know, that was the idea. So consistently, this professor who was interviewing, he consistently asked me, what is the problem with this experimental design? So I thought about it and I said, it's a little lengthy. It takes a very long time. So we never really finish the experiment. It's just a demo. We don't finish the whole thing, things like that. He was like, no, but there's another fundamental problem with this experiment. What is it? And I really tried. I was thinking from all possible angles and directions, but I couldn't get the answer. And then at the end he said, you're using a potato which already has some sugar in it, which already has some starch in it. So that itself, you know, is a big problem with this experiment. So I was like, oh yeah, actually I never thought about it that way. And then I realized that, yeah, I mean, yeah, obviously you are putting something which already has a high amount of starch. There is bound to be endosmosis. I mean, even if you don't put sugar inside it. So anyway, that was the first round. I think after the first round, we were six people who were selected into the second round. And by then I was extremely nervous because it was like a smaller group, and we were, you know how it is before interviews, they're always discussing what did you do for a project, what was this and what was asked. When someone comes out of the room, they'll be like, kya pucha, what did they ask you? Things like that. So, but the second round, again, they asked me again to explain, this time using a board and a marker. So I had to explain another experiment. This time I explained the mitosis experiment that we generally conduct normally, the onion root tip where you have to see the stain and see the mitotic cells. So that I explained on the board with the, I have a method of explanation which uses a lot of diagrams. So I was drawing diagrams and I was explaining the whole thing to them. After that was done, they asked me some questions, whatever I remember, I'm recollecting right now. They asked me some molecular biology questions. So I remember one of the questions was that you are doing a PCR and suppose that you know that heat is needed to denature the DNA in PCR. What if you don't have that, you know, heat? Then how can you do a PCR without that? So I was thinking about, you have to denature, to separate karna two strands. So I was thinking we can use alkali or something like that to, you know, separate the two strands. Then he was not happy with that. Then I said, well, there's sonication. And he's like, but yeah, but the DNA will get shredded. Then any other way that you can. So I kept thinking, I mean, whatever I could answer. I don't know whether there was a right answer or a wrong answer to that. I was thinking of ways how you can separate the two strands, because that was the basic idea that, you know, high temperature karta hai toh, toh strand hota. So if you don't have temperature, something else that will separate the two strands. Another very important question which I really liked and which was very, it changed my way of thinking in a way, that was one of the professors asked me, can DNA be dissolved in water? Now this was a very simple question vaise toh, but we have never thought, I had never till then thought about it. Whether we always use TE buffer when we do any experiment, it's always a buffer that we use. So I was like, are pani mein DNA dissolve hoga kya? That's a brilliant question. But I really had no idea. So I started thinking, and I was thinking about the chemistry of DNA, you know, what kind of a molecule it is. And I said, it is a charged molecule. And I said, yeah, I think it should be dissolving water, but I wasn't sure. Because I hadn't thought about it at all. So I thought, I think it is possible to dissolve it in water, but I'm not sure. Then he said, will it dissolve in 70% ethanol? So I was again thinking, I was like, 70% ethanol, again the chemistry is different. 70% mein to 30% pani hai, 70% is alcohol. Alcohol mein again, how much, you know, charge is there, polarity hai, nahi hai. So that question really blew my mind. I answered to the best of my ability. It's just that I was not 100% sure. Arey, aise. Because see, these are questions that I had never thought of in my life. These were very new to me. But I'll tell you, the overall experience of the interview was very positive. I have been to many interviews in my life, and a lot of times interview panels, they ask very theoretical questions, or they barely ask anything which is enhancing your knowledge or adding to your knowledge. It is just some routine procedure most of the time. Sometimes they are also mean. I have seen interview panels, you know, pulling people down. And but this was a very nice experience in that sense that it made me think, it made me question whatever I was following all throughout. So I really enjoyed that interview. But of course, at that moment, I was extremely nervous. I don't know. I didn't know what the result, you know, what would be the end result. So then that got done. I think by afternoon, we were free. And then, well, the rest is history. I got selected and then I joined ICF in 2016. And I was mainly involved in the conducting of the BSMS practicals. ICF Pune has a 5-year bachelor master integrated program, which is BSMS. So they have a compulsory biology lab component in the first 3 semesters. So this 3 semesters lab, we were a team. We were a group of 3 people or 2 people who would handle the lab during the experiments. We had to do everything right from preparing the reagents to setting up the lab to explaining the difficulties and discussing it to grading the journals. So it was a great experience overall. I was doing it for 3 years up until last year, 2019. And right now I'm on a different project. I'm still in ICER, but I work on a different project now. Yeah, so that is regarding the interview and my journey into ICER.
Currently, you're working on some research project?
No. So right now, what I'm working on is it is a outreach kind of project wherein students come from outside. They come from schools and colleges outside ICER, and we conduct molecular biology workshops for these students. They are either 1 day workshops or 3 day workshops, depending upon the level of the students. As in, like 9th to 12th students, they have a 1 day workshop, or the college students and postgraduate students, it's a 3 day workshop. So that is what I'm working on currently. There is a lot of curiosity about the course in ICER and how it is taught, and so I think about that I will in few words I'll talk about that. Students generally are very eager to know ki ICER Pune mein kya kya kaise sikhate hain, how is it. What I have observed is mostly the practical part of it, the lab part of it. So I will definitely talk about that more. The theory part of it, I think I'm not the best person to comment on that. But the first thing that struck me was that it's a very interdisciplinary course. They try to teach you biology from not just a biological perspective, but from a physics, chemistry, mathematical point of view. So that is a very new, fresh approach that I found extremely fascinating, and it was a great eye-opener to me that biology can be taught like this also. It is not just about mugging up names and just remembering stuff and writing it down. Those are things that generally students find boring about biology, or that's why they don't like biology, or drawing diagrams and things like that people don't like. Some students don't enjoy, so they avoid it. But here the approach is much different. They try to teach any concept from a science perspective and not a purely biological perspective. So that made even the experiments very, very interesting. So we began with obviously microscopy and things like that, very basic experiments, and then we went to cellular level where we were looking at proteins and the biochemistry part of it. Then we went inside the nucleus, and then DNA, RNA, molecular biology techniques. Then there was something to do with model organisms. The advantage of having this in a research institute is that there is a lot of accessibility to get a model organism, something which is very difficult otherwise. That is not the case here. So we had a wide variety of model organisms that the kids could see, including live mice were brought into the lab, and experiments were done on them just to show them some simple experiments, nothing to do with surgery or non-invasive methods, but interesting experiments. So that kind of exposes them to even if I don't like biology, I get a taste of biology, and then I can think whether I want to really pursue biology in the future. So we begin like that, and the third semester course was excellently designed. So those were the experiments where the students had they had an open end. There was no answer given to them beforehand. कि आप ये करोगे तो आपको ये मिलेगा, ऐसा नहीं था. इट वॉज समथिंग दैट वी जस्ट गेव देम अ ब्रॉड आउटलाइन, द फ्रेमवर्क वॉज गिवन टू देम, एंड देन दे कुड फिल इट अप द वे दे वॉन्टेड. समटाइम्स दे कुड आस्क देयर ओन क्वेश्चंस, मेनी अ टाइम्स इट वॉज लाइक दैट. द प्रोफेसर हु कंडक्टेड द एक्सपेरिमेंट्स वुड गिव देम अ फ्री हैंड अबाउट हाउ टू कंडक्ट द एक्सपेरिमेंट्स. इंटरप्रिटेशन वॉज अ लॉट ऑफ एम्फेसिस वॉज ऑन इंटरप्रिटेशन. यू गेट सम रिजल्ट, बट हाउ आर यू गोइंग टू इंटरप्रिट इट. देयर वॉज अ lot of emphasis on being honest and not copy pasting material directly from the internet. So about plagiarism, things like that are taught to them in the first and second year of their bachelors. So I mean, these are young kids, but I think that kind of changes their perspective towards biology. The third semester lab especially was very popular, and it also had mathematics. So there were softwares that the kids used to run to answer a particular question. So it was all in all a very different kind of a lab. That is where we stopped with the biology curriculum in terms of the lab. Mm-hmm. Then the kids used to select their own, I think the third year onwards, they select their subjects, the subjects mm-hmm. that they want to take. Sometimes they take more than one. Sometimes they combine, they take physics and biology or math and chemistry, or I mean they can pick and choose. So then they don't have a lab component. Then it is more about theory, and then they from the third year onwards, they also work in labs. So they directly get an exposure to lab work, how people work in a lab, what are the etiquettes of the lab, etc., etc. So they start to think about taking up research as a career seriously. I think from that point onwards, they have to really think whether they want to take up research or not. Some of them are really into it and they take up research, but I think some of them are also of the opinion that no, this is not my cup of tea and I just want to finish the degree, which is also fine. They finish their BSMS and then they go on to do something else. Somebody takes up an MBA or so. There is a diverse, there's a vast, but I think majority of students, they do end up going into research. They take up PhDs. Most of them end up in universities abroad. But I think overall it gives them a lot of early exposure. There are a lot of talks that are always happening on campus, wherein very eminent scientists from all over the world, they come and they give their they give presentations, talks about their work. So there's a lot of exposure that is available to them very easily. At the same time, it's a tough course. It is difficult. They have to be on toes 24/7. They're on the campus. They cannot stay at home. The students have to be on campus. So they are always at the beck and call. Sometimes 6 baje ko quiz hota hai aur bhagte hote hain. I'm like, kahan ja rahe ho ma'am? Quiz hai abhi, isliye hum ja rahe hain quiz ke liye. So they're always on their toes. It's a little hectic, yeah. But it also is, they have a lot of other activities also. It's not just studies. So they have a quiz club, they have a drama club, they have a music club, you name it and it's there. They want to learn a foreign language, it's there. So there is all-round development jo hum bolte hain ya hum jo sunte hain bahar, jo hamesha bola jata hai. But वो यहाँ पर actually होने के possibilities हैं. Of course ये student का ये है level, enthusiasm level, और वो कितना क्या क्या कर पाता है, that is obviously a limiting factor. But there are opportunities, and if you're really interested, वो explore करने का opportunity you have. And also, even though this is a science institute, I think isme physics, chemistry, mathematics, biology to hai. Uske alawa, there is also courses in earth and climate sciences. And there is also courses in humanities and social sciences. So some of the students are also drawn towards these courses. It's not that ki physics, chemistry, math, ya biology hi lena hai. So some of them do take up projects in ECS, Earth and Climate Sciences, or Humanities and Social Sciences. So that way they also have, they can explore that part of education as well.
तो इसमें ये पूछना था मुझे, तो इसके लिए अलग एग्जाम है या बीएसएमएस के बच्चे डायरेक्टली इसमें जा सकते हैं सोशल साइंस या क्लाइमेटिक साइंस के लिए?
नहीं नहीं, इसी में जैसे वो ट्वेल्थ में एग्जाम देके आ जाते हैं, सो दे हैव ऑल द ऑप्शंस. उनको पहले दो ईयर तो कंपलसरी सब्जेक्ट्स होते हैं. अभी सिलेबस अभी रिवाइज हो गया है, तो अभी 3 सेमेस्टर्स उनको कंपलसरी सब करना पड़ता है. पहले 4 सेमेस्टर्स करना पड़ता था. So now 3 semesters they have to work on these compulsory subjects. So it's not ke mujhe math mein interest hai to main bio drop kar sakti hu, ya mera 12th mein biology nahi tha to main bio, aisa nahi hota. Tumko karna padta hai, 3 semesters karna padta hai. After that then you can choose from whatever you want. To wahan pe unko wo option hota hai ki wo HSS ke subjects le sakte hain, ECS ke subjects le sakte hain.
It's like teaching से ज़्यादा यहाँ पे तो learning है, like every day, every experiment. I think you yourself is learning, right? There's so much to do.
Absolutely, and there is a lot to do. There is a lot, and it is very broad minded process. आप कहीं पर भी अपने आप को सोच को ये नहीं कर सकते, narrow नहीं कर सकते. Because अगर वैसा करोगे तो actually scientific thinking जो है वो आएगी नहीं, बिकॉज इफ यू वांट टू थिंक फ्रॉम अ लॉजिकल रैशनल पर्सपेक्टिव, कुछ भी सोचना है, क्वेश्चन का आंसर निकालना है, तो ऑब्वियसली सारे डायरेक्शन से सोचना पड़ता है, मल्टी डायरेक्शनल थॉट्स होने चाहिए. तो लर्निंग तो बहुत अच्छा एक्सपीरियंस रहा, बच्चों के साथ मजा भी आया, उनको डांट भी पड़ी है बहुत बार, डरते भी थे बच्चे, और बट इट वाज अ नाइस एक्सपीरियंस. आई रियली एंजॉयड माय टाइम वर्किंग इन द लैब, इट वाज अ ग्रेट एक्सपीरियंस.
नहीं, बहुत मजा आया पूर्णिमा आपकी जर्नी की एक्सपीरियंस सुन के. थैंक यू सो मच फॉर शेयरिंग.
नो प्रॉब्लम, नो प्रॉब्लम. थैंक यू.
Thank you, Poonima.